What started as an ordinary day of playing soccer turns into Mark's worst nightmare when his father, Jack, arrives with a grim look. Mark instantly knows something is wrong. Jack takes him to the hospital, where they find his mother, Janice, lying in bed. Janice awakens and asks why he didn't wake her. Mark replies that he thought she should rest, and Janice weakly smiles, saying she'd rather see him. On the day of his mother's funeral, Mark isolates himself from the guests and his father. Meanwhile, Jack tells his brother Wallace that he can't go on a business trip and leave his son. Wallace persuades Jack that going to Tokyo to close his deal might mean he won't have to leave Mark again, and reminds him that Mark will be staying with family, not strangers. Jack reluctantly agrees and decides to take Mark to Wallace's place in Maine himself, hoping to spend some quality time together. Wallace and his daughter, Connie, greet them warmly. Wallace's wife, Susan, remarks how it's been 10 years since she last saw Mark. Their son Henry greets him wearing a mask and gives another mask to Mark, saying he made one for him so they could be brothers. During dinner, Susan tells Jack that she has spoken to Alice, a therapist who works with Wallace at the hospital. As they eat, Henry playfully kicks Mark's legs under the table, and when Mark does the same, they both start laughing. Henry then shows Mark how to crack a lobster shell. As Jack prepares to leave, he reminds Mark that he's going to Tokyo, so he won't have to leave him again. He reassures his son that he'll be back in 2 weeks and encourages him to have fun. The next day, Mark wakes to the sound of Henry shouting outside as he plays. Mark quickly gets dressed to join his cousin, but on his way down, he spots a child's room. He steps inside briefly, looks around, and quickly goes downstairs to eat breakfast. Henry takes Mark to his treehouse with Connie watching from the ground. As the boys climb the tree, Henry reaches the top first, and when Mark is about to reach, the branch Mark is standing on snaps. Henry grabs him quickly and jokingly asks if Mark thinks he could fly if he lets go. Mark doesn't answer and continues to ask for help. Eventually, Henry manages to pull him up into the treehouse, and they lie down breathlessly before starting to goof around. Later, the boys play inside an abandoned factory, breaking windows until the caretaker chases them away. They end up in a cemetery, where they find a well. Henry uses it as a hiding place for his cigarettes and lights one up. He offers it to Mark, who reluctantly tries it but quickly says that cigarettes cause cancer. Henry asks if he saw his mother after she died. When Mark says he wasn't allowed to, Henry insists he should have. He asks Mark what his mother looked like the last time he saw her. After Mark describes her, Henry reveals he took a good look at his little brother, Richard, who was just a few months old, when he drowned in the bathtub, leaving Mark shocked. Henry describes his brother as completely blue and tells Mark he should have looked at his mother's eyes and lips and touched her skin to see if she was hot or cold. This makes Mark mad, and he demands Henry stop talking about his mother. Henry reasons that he's just trying to be scientific, but Mark threatens to hit him if he doesn't shut up. Henry dares him to try and, as he throws his cigarette down the well, says he'll throw Mark down there too. Henry then apologizes, saying he knows how he'd feel if he didn't have a mother. The two boys make up by shaking hands. The next morning, a dog suddenly started chasing them, forcing them to sprint like never before. As they reached the end of the bridge, Henry quickly shut the door on the dog, leaving it barking angrily on the other side. Henry couldn't resist taunting the dog by barking back at it. The boys go to a cliff overlooking the sea, where they see Susan staring into the water. Henry explains that Susan often goes there to think about her late son, Richard. He then takes Mark to see his new crossbow. Henry takes his makeshift crossbow outside and aims it at a cat. Mark reminds Henry to just scare the cat, not hit it. Henry agrees, but when he shoots, he misses the cat by only a few inches. Henry is disappointed that he didn't hit the cat. While Mark tosses and turns in bed that night, he hears a sound from the corridor and sees a woman in white walking by. Thinking it's his mother, Mark follows her downstairs as she heads to the living room. When Mark calls out to her, she turns around, and he realizes it's Susan. She hugs and comforts Mark as he cries, promising that she's right there with him. As Mark tells Susan he misses his mother, Henry quietly watches them from upstairs. The next day, as Mark and Connie play, Henry calls Mark and tells him it's time to go outside. When Connie tries to join them, Henry pushes her away and leaves her behind. The boys head outside with Henry's makeshift crossbow, looking for a target. When Henry spots the dog that chased them the other day, he shoots it, shocking Mark as the dog whimpers in pain. They then bring the dead dog in a sack and drop it in the well. Henry hums a song, leaving Mark really uneasy and avoiding him. Susan and Mark are looking at a photo of Richard. He comments that she probably misses him. Susan admits she does. Just then, Henry shows up and invites Mark to his shed, saying he has something to show him. Mark is reluctant, but Susan encourages him to go with Henry. In the shed, Henry reveals a dummy he made, calling it Mr. Highway. When Mark asks what he plans to do with it, Henry gives vague answers, saying it depends on whether Mark will help him. With Mark's help, Henry takes the dummy outside and suddenly throws it off a bridge, causing a massive road accident. Henry watches with pleasure as the cars crash into each other, while Mark looks on in horror. Afterward, the boys rush away from the scene and hide in a tunnel. Mark gets upset, telling Henry that he could have killed people. Henry nonchalantly replies that he did it with Mark's help. Shocked, Mark insists he didn't know Henry was going to throw the dummy off the bridge. Henry simply responds that he feels sorry for Mark because he doesn't know how to have fun. That night, Mark listens to the news report about the car accident. He's about to go into Wallace's office to tell him what happened, but Henry taunts him, implying that Wallace will believe him over Mark. Later, Henry asks his cousin if he's okay, but Mark only tells him to leave him alone. Connie then enters the room to inform them that Susan's letting them go skating the following day. This upsets Henry, and he asks Connie what he said about coming to his room. When Connie doesn't answer, he pulls her ear, telling her she's not allowed in his room, making the little girl cry. Mark breaks them apart and pins Henry, saying that Connie can stay. The boys start fighting and pulling each other's hair, and while Connie calls for help, Henry asks Mark if he'd be sad if something were to happen to Connie. Henry remarks that accidents happen and tells Mark to ask his mother about Richard. When Susan enters the room, Henry tells her they are just playing a dumb game, and with Mark backing him up, Susan believes them and leaves. The following day, Alice finds Mark at the playground while he's watching Connie play. Alice says he must have forgotten about their appointment, but Mark tells her that he just doesn't feel like talking. He then asks the therapist what makes people evil, but Alice says evil is just a word people use when they get tired of trying to understand someone and that there's a reason for everything. Alice then asks Mark if he thinks he's evil because he let his mother die, but Mark doesn't answer her question. Instead, Mark asks her if a boy is considered to be evil if he does terrible things just because he likes them. When Alice says she doesn't believe in evil, Mark tells her she should before going back to Connie. During dinner, Wallace tells the boys to babysit Connie since he's taking Susan out to dinner. After that, Henry tells his mother that Mark wants to move into Richard's room since he seems to like it there. Mark tries denying it, but the adults can't hear him because they're already arguing about whether Mark should move into their little boy's room or not. Wallace insists that it might be a good idea for Mark to stay there, but Susan is adamant that she isn't ready for that to happen yet. Wallace asks her to give it some thought, but Susan is determined to leave Richard's room as it is. Henry smirks as he watches his parents argue while Mark keeps trying to tell them that Henry is making it up. Susan leaves the table, which satisfies Henry. He happily watches his mother cry in Richard's room that night. When Susan notices him, Henry walks up to her and comforts her, telling her not to cry. As Susan and Wallace go to the restaurant, the kids turn off all the lights in the house to play hide and seek. Connie hides while the boys try to find her, but Henry finds her first. When Mark hears Connie scream, he immediately rushes to follow her voice and finds Henry on top of her, tickling her. Feeling uncomfortable, Mark offers to read Connie a story instead of playing hide and seek, and she agrees. After reading her a story, Mark sleeps in Connie's room to guard her against Henry. The following morning, Mark wakes up and finds Connie's bed empty. As he goes downstairs, he hears Susan and Wallace talking about Richard. Susan still blames herself for what happened to her son, saying she left him in the tub with less than 6 inches of water to answer the phone. Seeing that his wife is upset, Wallace offers to drive Connie to the Andersons, but Susan tells him that Connie went skating with Henry at Miller's Pond. Mark wastes no time heading to the pond. It's filled with people, and as soon as Mark spots the siblings, he rushes onto the frozen surface, slipping and bumping into people without skates. Henry takes Connie to a restricted part of the pond and pushes her toward thin ice. As soon as Connie stands, the ice breaks and she falls in. Everyone gathers around, watching as Henry pretends to help his sister. Some people in the crowd keep Mark from helping Connie, so he's forced to stay behind the line. Henry extends his hand to Connie, who struggles to keep afloat, but each time she reaches for his hand, Henry pulls it away. Finally, Connie starts sinking, and only then do two men decide to step in and break a small portion of the ice to save her, all while Henry calmly watches from the side. Upon hearing the news, Susan immediately goes to the hospital, where Wallace assures her that their daughter is fine. After Connie's accident, Mark finds Susan by the cliff and tells her that Henry pushed Connie toward the thin ice. He explains that Henry has said he hates Connie and tried to kill her, warning Susan that Henry could do it again. This only upsets Susan, and she slaps Mark, insisting that he's lying. Susan asserts that she loves Henry and asks Mark never to come to her with his lies again. That night at the hospital, Henry enters Connie's room and, as he watches her sleep, slowly tries to get one of her pillows. Susan then turns on the light, startling Henry. He says he's worried about his sister, and Susan tells him that Connie probably won't remember what happened on the ice. When she asks Henry what really happened, he insists that it was an accident. Later, Mark talks to his father on the phone and tells him what Henry did to their neighbor's dog and to Connie, saying Henry tried to kill her. Shocked by his son's accusations, Jack asks for Susan or Wallace, but Mark tells him that they won't believe him. Jack then asks his son to see his therapist and tell her what he just told him, and Mark agrees. Mark goes to Alice's house, where he finds Henry talking to her. Alice says Henry told her that the two of them are having problems, and Mark gets mad, asserting that Henry is the problem. Thinking that Alice is siding with Henry, Mark immediately leaves. Henry then starts making up stories about Mark, saying his cousin scares him sometimes. After his session with Alice, Henry finds Mark in the treehouse and taunts him. Mark tells Henry that everyone will soon learn the truth about him, especially after he tells Susan what Henry did. Henry says that his mother will believe him over Mark, but Mark tells him that Susan is his mother too, saying that his own mother chose Susan as a way of coming back. Unhappy, Henry warns Mark not to mess with him while Mark climbs down the tree. That night, Mark goes to the kitchen to look for some food and finds Henry standing there, subtly hinting that he's poisoned all the food in the refrigerator. Henry then calls his parents, and when they go to the kitchen, they find Mark dumping all their food in the sink, claiming that Henry is trying to poison them. Susan tries to calm Mark down, and when he finally does, Wallace takes him to Richard's room. The next day, Susan goes to Henry's shed, where she accidentally finds Richard's rubber duck hidden in one of Henry's masks. Henry suddenly arrives, and when Susan shows him the rubber duck, Henry says it was his before it became Richard's. Susan asks Henry why he took it, adding that she was looking for it after the accident. Henry innocently replies that he just wanted to have something to remember Richard by. When Henry asks for the toy back, Susan refuses, which upsets Henry. He then tries grabbing it away from his mother, and when he finally manages to get it, he runs away and goes to the cemetery, where he drops the duck into the well. Later on, as Mark finds Henry watching himself in the mirror, Henry hints that he plans to hurt his mother. Mark threatens to kill him first, and when Henry mocks him, Mark grabs a pair of scissors and jumps on Henry, placing the scissors against his throat. Henry dares Mark to slit him, but Wallace suddenly enters the room and pulls Mark off his son, saying he could actually hurt Henry. Wallace takes Mark downstairs and tells him that he'll call Alice. Mark tries to flee, but Wallace immediately catches him and locks him up in the study room. From the window, Mark watches as Henry lures Susan into the woods. Left with no other options, Mark breaks the window. Wallace almost catches him, but Mark manages to escape through the door. In the woods, Susan asks Henry what really happened the night Richard died. Henry claims that he was playing downstairs. Susan doesn't believe him, and when she asks Henry if he killed Richard, Henry looks her straight in the eyes and asks what she would do if he did. This takes Susan aback, but she says they'll get help and asks her son to trust her. Henry says he can't, saying he'd rather die than be sent away. Henry runs, and when Susan goes after him and reaches the cliff, Henry appears behind her. He pushes his mother off the cliff, but Susan manages to grab a branch sticking out of the cliff. When Henry is about to drop a huge rock on her, Mark arrives and tackles him. As the boys struggle, Susan slowly pulls herself up. She eventually reaches the top and sees the boys rolling over the cliff. Susan grabs Henry and Mark by their hands. Mark starts to slip. Henry keeps begging his mother to save him, but with no strength left, Susan lets go of him to save Mark. Henry falls to his death while Susan hugs her nephew. Later on, Mark reflects on the accident, wondering whether Susan would make the same choice if she had to do it over. Although he'll always wonder, Mark is sure that he will never ask Susan about it.